Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome to the job site. Here we are on another window painting day, and today we are eliminating winter. We'll try eliminating winter right here at the grocery outlet in Albany, Oregon. And here's winter. There it is. And today, for your pleasure, I will be eliminating winter. So that should make you feel good. That means spring is right around the corner. And that's what I'm painting up here today, a little bit of spring. I'm going to take you along with me. Stay tuned as we eliminate winter and bring spring upon the glorious Oregon countryside. Here we go. Check it out. Stripped the window, got rid of winter, thank God. And now we're doing a little bit of spring, a little bit of color, some yellow and pop colors. Anyways, this one's done for today and probably come back for summer. All right, guys, I'm gonna meet you back at the motorhome. Until then, check this out. So glad you can make it. Now, maybe some of you guys noticed right behind me over there, that old table, it's gone. Yep, took it out of there completely. And that section over there is now what's going to be referred to as the music room. And you can see the guitar over there. I was playing the guitar earlier, just kind of relaxing. Music helps me unwind. It's totally a part of my relaxation method. And if I'm playing music on any level, if it's a guitar or drums or what have you, it clears the mind. It makes you kind of just think about that. It's meditation, kind of. Anyway, so that's one of the big reasons I like playing music. And I want my rig to be a big part of those things that I really enjoy in life. So I told you I was going to be getting a cocktail table over there. Right, or a pub table as it's known, or a bar table, and I am to some extent. What you see over there is a big empty space, and it's going to actually be a cocktail drum set. That's right, that will double as a table. And it's, if you're not familiar with the cocktail drum set, I'm going to show you a picture of it right now. Yep, that's a cocktail drum set. And as you can see, it's very small, fits in a very small space. And so that's going to leave me a lot more room over there than that table ever did. And I'm going to make a little cover for the top of the main drum there to create a table. As well as when I want to play, I just pull the table part off and have an instant drum set. I'm getting at least one bar stool for it. That's really cool. I found over at Guitar Center yesterday. And it has a Zildjian logo on it. And if you're not familiar with Zildjian, they make cymbals. And that's the cymbals I play. And that's the cymbals that this particular drum set will have on it. In fact, the cymbals I have going on my new drum set slash table are chrome. and they match all the new chrome stuff that I'm doing in there, including like the work on the stove and the backdrops. And I'm adding a lot of accents with not chrome so much as a stainless steel look or aluminum, but it's turning out pretty cool. And I think that by adding this new kit in there as a table with the new chrome cymbals and my new speaker system going in here, and then the hookups over here for the guitars and that type of thing, are going to be pretty unique to the RV thing, at least as far as I've seen. I'm sure they're out there, but for this safari trek, it's going to be definitely one of a kind. So you guys stay tuned. Got a lot more coming from the Honk Guy channel. Not only upgrades, but we also got some traveling to do. So, oh yeah, did some work to the bathroom too. It's almost back together. And if you didn't know, I pretty much had it torn all apart. Let's go take a look. I'll show you. I need to get up and stretch my legs anyways. I'm way too comfortable. Alright guys, so here we are in the bathroom. This is something I don't generally do, is hang out with people in my bathroom. But hey, it's a party. Let's all party. So, you can see my bathroom's fairly big for a small RV. And then with all these mirrors around here, it really makes everything look super big. And when people come in and see this RV, they're tripping on how big the bathroom is. But anyways, I got a porcelain toilet down here. And if you guys know anything about RV toilets, porcelain is the way to go. And this is a high-end toilet. I just installed a brand new faucet and drain in the sink here. It's still the original sink. I thought that would work. We added the elephant up here. I don't know if you can see that, a little dark in here. Got monogram towels for everything, and I found those at the thrift store, believe it or not, but they got my last name monogram on there. Got some plantage going in here to give it a safari look, because we got the elephant on the shower door. I put a brand new drain down in the shower here. I got brand new soap dispensers that are going to be mounted to the wall in there. I just put this cabinet in tonight, and it holds all the monogram towels up there. Just added this mirror back in. It was way up here and it was really funky. Got this stool. So now we have this kind of unique thing. I want to put a couple towel racks right here that are wood, like the ones I put over here. And got a new little carpet for in here. And what else? Oh, of course, you got to have your Mystic pyramid. And if you are an RV dweller or a van dweller, I suggest you get one of these. It can determine your fate for you. I found this one at the thrift store for like $2. Let's see what it has to say today. We'll see if you guys can hear it. So here we go. Is anybody actually going to watch this video? The outcome may surprise you. Wow, did you hear that? It said the outcome may surprise you. So I think that might be good. That's good or bad. Anyways, that's kind of in the general response it will give you on most questions, but it's kind of fun when you're sitting in there on the John contemplating life and you don't have any answers. That thing always has the answer for you. So anyways, just hanging out here. Glad I could show you the restroom. That's the first part of the tour. I'm going to make this a multi-part tour. I could show you more on, you know, the toilet flushing, maybe the faucet running, but you guys get the gist of it, I think. You're RVers. So that's it. The new converted Trek turning into a mobile studio slash music room slash off-the-grid living slash just really cool, fun way to get around slash office slash... Oh, yeah. I'm putting a full mixing console in here for video, so we'll be able to do live mixing video. I have that out in the garage right now, but it has a perfect spot for it right there. And with the audio up above and with all the components right in that area, it will be perfect there. So we'll be able to do live mixing wherever we're at, which is going to be awesome. And then we can deliver that right to the internet or to the hard drive or whatever. But that's coming. I'll be doing upgrades on the computer, on the video mixing system, on the upgrades to hooking up the whole entire communication / entertainment / electronics and video console mixing system over here. And that's going to make this thing truly one of a kind. Oh, and let me show you the stove. I'm almost done with the installation on the stove, guys. It's been pretty easy. The only thing, it's just been pouring rain out here for days on end. I have made down here a stainless steel hearth, basically, for this thing. So it covers up the gas pipe that comes down here, and then the wires for the new LEDs. Yes, I've installed LEDs behind this, so this whole thing behind it is going to light up. I'm putting a switch right here for the LEDs, which isn't in yet. But outside of that, I got to hook the tank up to the gas line down below and get this switch put in and then just drill my hole right here. And we will have flames there, people. So it's not going to be very much longer and I will have that thing all fired up. And that makes me kind of happy, too. So making people happy, making myself happy, rocking the earth today right here in the Trek. Trekking the earth here soon in the future. Hope you guys are subscribing. I need more viewership. So if you know RVers out there, any of you RVers watching me, tell him, hey, check him out, man. He's got things going on a little bit different out of the north. He's whacked out, man. This guy is a little bit whacked out. You just tell him that. But check out his channel, and it's all good, man. I'm going to show you some fun things. So stay tuned, Trek the Earth, and till next time, I'm the Honk Guy. Out.